Good morning. It's a cold one and it's windy. I'm back out again. I'm going onto the field where I found the Henry V8 for half grape the other day. I've still got a lot of that field to do. It is a quiet field, I must admit. But when you hit something, you know. So I'm going to give it a go, see what happens. Anyway, see you on the first. Just had this up reading a 27. It's got to be a button. Let's have a look. Could be a coin. No, it's a button. Feel the shank. Yep, let's move on. One button. I could just tell by the signal reading a 33 that the target was virtually on top. And I think that's a musket ball. I think. A bloody big one. Yeah, that's definitely a musket ball. Lovely. Right, let's move on. Moved on to this pasture. The other field was, I wasn't getting anything at all except for a button. And I think I've got another button now reading a 23. Sorry, 27, and I just clumped it out there. There it is. No, that's a coin, I think. I think, I'm not too sure. Not too sure what that is. I'm just going to give that a clean, and then I'll get straight back to you. I think this is a little farthing. You can just make out Britannia there. Possibly a date there, but I can't really see it. But you can see Britannia quite clearly. Worn round all the edges and completely worn on the other side. But nice little find, I suppose. Can't complain. This was a right scratchy signal. No idea what it is. No idea. Get that muck out the middle. No idea what that is. Okay, let's move on. This was reading 33 on the legend, and there's quite a deep hole, and it's just there. That has to be a coin. Completely worn. I'm not going to get much off that. That's good. Another coin. Very thin. Right, let's move on. Just a four roller, reading a 32. That's all it is. Right, let's move on. This is a reading of 23. Look at the size of that. That is one big spoon. Very big. It's a pity that it's broke. That's been on the ground a long time. Look at the size of it. Right, let's move on. This was reading 23. Another part of a spoon. I don't think it's part of the big one I just found. That could be, I don't know. So we give it a clean. Could be silver. I don't know. Right, let's move on. This was an eye reading of 45. I turned the sod and I can see it. Just there. Don't know what it is. That's silver. That is definitely silver. Look at that. completely worn. But it's got a milled edge. Not much on it, but silver. Happy days. Happy days. Right, let's move on. Just had a look at that silver coin, and there's a face facing left. You can see his nose there. His or hers, I do not know. But quite happy with that. Very happy. Not much on the other side. Right, let's carry on. This was an eye reading of 50. I've not touched it yet, it's there, and I think there may be something else in the hole, which I'll check in a minute. Now that's bigger than a penny. I wonder what that is. That's bigger than a pre-decimal. Well, I'm going to leave that there, and then I'm going to check the old again and see if there's anything else in it. No idea what this is, but you can see all the writing around the edge. Much bigger than a pre-decimal penny. I'm going to have to gently clean that when I get back. No idea what it is. A bit of weight to it as well. Looks like there could be something on there. Just there, but no idea what it is. No idea. There was nothing else to the in that hole. I thought there was, but there wasn't. Right, let's move on. Well, it's turned out lovely now. Wind's dropped. There's a big buzzard flying up there, just at the top of the tree line. Yeah, I'm just doing this strip along here where I just had the silver coin and that big item, that bigger coin thing. So I'm just going up and down here, then I'll probably call it a day. Yeah, see you on the next. This was reading 33, and it's in that clump there. It looks like a button, I think. Let's break it open. Yeah, that's a button. Yeah, reading at 33. Yeah, it's definitely a button. That last object I found was there's nothing on it at all. Okay, let's move on. This is reading about 23. There's the imprint, and there's the, it's got to be a button. Let's grab it. Yeah, that's a button. Yeah, nice imprint. One button. Right, let's move on. This is reading 35, 36. And it's a very, very small button. Very small. Still got a shank. Yeah, that's all it is. One small button. Right, let's move on. This is a reading of 43, and it's there somewhere in there. Let's get the knife. See anything? A couple of stones. Let's check that again. Quite close to the surface. It's got to be a bit of scrap, I think. There it is. There it is. pound, a pound coin. Oh, I didn't expect that. Did not expect that. Okay, let's move on. This is a reading of 27, and it's in Pug. Somewhere there. There it is. No, it's not. There it is. The old 10p. That's too... Oh dear. Old 10p. Better than nothing. Okay, let's move on.
Couple of little friends here following me around. Hello, mate. How are you? Where's your brother? Come on in. Here he comes. Here he comes. Hello, mate. Don't get nicking my shoes. No. Right, I'm going home. I've had enough today. And I'll see you on the roundup. Right then, let's go through the finds. Look at the size of this. Jar huge. I'll go in my scrap bucket. Completely battered. It's the largest spoon I've ever found. Going from the top here, let's have a look at this. No idea what this is. It's got a pointy end there. I reckon that would have been attached to something. No idea. Musket ball. Another part of a spoon. It's got some SA marks. It's got markings there, but I don't think it's silver. Even though there's a bit of silver showing through. I reckon it was silver plated. Buttons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 buttons. Nothing really on them. Going on from the coins. I don't know what this is. Do not think it's a coin. It's probably been used for collecting tools or whatever. And you hand this in to get your tool. And they know which person who's what tool they've got. I would say, I don't know. I'm just making that up. One pound coin. Queen Elizabeth. 10 pence piece. I want to say a crusty Georgian coin. This battered up, I would say, was a farthing. Completely worn, battered. Silver coin. Can't make out who it is. But you can see the image there. That was a nice little find. Nothing much on the back. Little bit of writing. But that's about it. But somebody can give me an ID on that. Let's get it. Is it that way? I'm not too sure. This nearly blew my ears off. It's a Portuguese coin. And this one's dated 1738. So that was my best find of a day next to the silver. I've never had one of these before. But it's jar huge. Compare it to a pound. So that's my finds for today. And I'll see you on the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe. It does mean a lot to me. Take care, everybody.